Hello everyone, my name is Vos Josef and I am Mr. Musette. I am an illustrator from Romania and in my free time I create art and illustration related videos. If you are new to my channel and you will enjoy my content, feel free to subscribe and click the notification bell to be notified every time I upload a new video. After all the October illustration challenge videos and the zodiac sign illustration series, I decided to create something new, and as I mentioned in my preview video, I preparing some new interesting projects, or at least interesting for me and hopefully for you as well. One of the projects is this custom painted denim jacket, which you might already saw in the title of the video. A few months ago, I custom painted a pair of shoes with Posca pens, and after that, I was thinking that I could do this again but with something different. So, as I saw that on YouTube, it's a big trend, this denim jacket customization, I went to a local mass market and they had these denim jackets on sale. So I bought some of them. After a lot of thinking and planning, I decided to paint on one of them an illustrated portrait of Frida Kahlo, one of my favorite painters. If you don't know who is Frida Kahlo, I will tell you about her. Frida Kahlo was a Mexican painter known for her many portraits, self-portraits, and works inspired by the nature and artifacts of Mexico. Inspired by the country's popular culture, her paintings often had strong autobiographical elements and mixed realism with fantasy. She is one of my favorite painters and artists of all time, and I am quite obsessed of her work. And you might already saw some of my illustrations inspired by her person or by her work. So as I said already, for a long time I wanted to try out this denim jacket customization, but I never wanted to buy some textile paints because they are not cheap. And I already spent a lot of money on other art supplies which I really like and I use. So I knew that you can paint on textile with acrylics. And I still have two sets of acrylics. But my concern was that after I finished the painting on the jacket, this will not last too much in time. So I needed to figure it out something to create this project and to not spend too much money on it. So I documented myself about other artists who are painting with acrylics on fabrics and what they are using for this technique. So I found out that in order to paint with acrylics on any kind of textile, you need to mix your acrylics with some kind of medium. So I went to the local art supply shop and I bought this medium for textiles and fabrics from Pentart. And I came home and I started to plan out my illustration, which I want to paint on the back of the jacket. After I was done with the sketch, I scanned the illustration and I printed out at the size I wanted to be transferred. I cut out the illustration because I wanted only that part to be on the textile and not anything else extra. I drew the shape of the illustration on the jacket with a fine liner, and after that I started to paint the base coat, which I did with a white acrylic mixed with the medium. I think that I needed to apply 2 or 3 coats of white. After the coats of the white were dried on the jacket, I took some carbon papers and I transferred the illustration using a ballpoint pen. Most of the time I'm using this technique to transfer some of the illustrations on canvas, but I don't really like this because it's very messy. However, I was happy that this worked, and after the illustration was transferred, I started to paint. The thing is that every time you are mixing some colors you need to mix in it some medium for textiles as well, because otherwise this will not last in time, and that's what you want to achieve, right? The painting part took me several days, but not because I painted all day long, because I couldn't do that because of my commissions. Most of the time I started to paint in the evenings and lasted until I was very tired and I went to sleep. But after I was done with the painting and even with the black line art, I was really happy how this turned out. But after you painted the jacket, it's not the last step of the process. It's one more thing that you need to do, which I didn't film for this video. You take some baking paper or something similar to that, you put it over the painting, and on that you are fixing the painting with a hot iron. But you need to be careful that the iron shouldn't be with the steam option on. I really enjoyed working on this project, and definitely I will do it again more than once, because I got not only one jacket but more of them, and I even considering to take commissions for those who are interested to paint a custom jacket for them. This jacket is available for purchase in my Etsy shop, which is linked in the description of this video, and there you can find some new original illustrations as well and other illustrated products. And even the shoes which I custom painted in a preview video, it's available there. And I will ship worldwide. So if you are interested in something like that, please check out my shop. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section what do you think about the end results. And what should I paint in the next jacket customization video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Until then, do not forget, life is a song, illustrate it.